Hi guys, and welcome back in Medical Scribe. In this video, we will talk about the superficial, the intermediate, and the deep terms. In the previous videos, we knew how to categorize the anatomical terms. And we said that we have terms that are independent to the anatomical position and to the anatomical planes. These terms will be divided into three subgroups. The first one is the superficial, intermediate, and deep. The second subgroup is the external and the internal, while the third subgroup is the proximal and the distal. And today, we will talk about the first subgroup of them. These three terms in the first subgroups, which are the superficial, intermediate, and deep, will describe the position of structures in relation to the surface of the body. That means, which structure is nearer to the body surface and which one is farther away from it. And we should focus on that these descriptions will be in comparison with another structure. And we will know what I mean throughout the upcoming examples. The first term is the superficial, which means near the surface, or which structure is closer to the surface than another structure. For example, if we say the muscles of the arm are superficial to the humerus bone. So if we take a cross-section of the arm, we will notice that the arm muscles is closer to the surface than the humerus, which is located in the center of the section. So the arm muscles is superficial to the humerus. Or if we say the sternum is superficial to the heart, that means the sternum bone will be in front of the heart, or nearer to the surface than the heart. And the last example to understand this term well is that the skin is superficial to the ribs. That means the skin is closer to the body surface than the ribs. So the superficial means near the surface of the body. Whereas the intermediate will mean that the structure will position in the middle, between a superficial structure and a deep structure. So if we say, the biceps muscle is intermediate between the skin and the humerus, that means the biceps muscle will be positioned in the middle between the skin, which is the superficial structure, and the humerus, which is the deep structure. So the meaning of the intermediate is in the middle. While the deep will mean the structure that is farther away from the surface of the body, and also in comparison with another structure. So if we return to our cross-section of the arm and say this time, the humerus is deep to the arm muscles. So in this case, that will mean the humerus bone is deeper or away from the body surface than the arm muscles, because the humerus is deep and in the center of the section. Or if we say, the heart is deep to the sternum, that means the heart will be behind the sternum or farther away from the surface in comparison with the sternum. And finally, if we say the stomach is deep to the abdominal wall, that will mean the stomach is deeper than the abdominal wall or behind the abdominal wall from the body surface or in comparison with the body surface. So this is the meaning of the deep term. And the last thing we have in this video, that is if we want to divide the body structures into superficial structures and deep structures, so we will put the skin and superficial fascia and the mammary gland in the superficial structures box. While the deep structure box will include the skeletal muscles and the viscera. So that was almost everything about the superficial, intermediate, and the deep terms. And that's it. I hope what I said makes sense. See you next video, and goodbye.